Hello, this is Jared, and I'm going to show you how to edit video with Final Cut Pro 10. You may be new to video editing or have used another application like iMovie or Premiere. Regardless of your background, this video is going to provide you an overview of the editing process with Final Cut. Before editing can begin, Final Cut Pro needs to be installed on your Mac. Open the Mac App Store and search for Final Cut Pro. Click on the price and follow the steps to complete the purchase and start the download. At the time of this recording, you can also get a free 30-day trial by going to apple.com. It took about 20 minutes to install on my machine. Once installed, click the Final Cut Pro 10 icon to open the app. This is the default Final Cut Pro 10 interface. There are four areas. At the top left is the browser. The middle is the viewer. To the right is the inspector. And at the bottom is the timeline. These areas can be resized and hidden. Use the shortcut Command-0 to return to the default layout. You may see this untitled library and an event with the date. To start with a brand new library and event, click on the untitled library and go to File, Close Library. Then go to File, New, Library. For this tutorial, video from editstock.com and the documentary Donut Dynamite is used. Continue watching to the end of this tutorial for a discount code. Name the new library and choose where it should be saved. The Movies folder is a great spot for saving libraries on your Mac. Video takes up a lot of space, so you can also store this library on an external hard drive. It's now time to import our video. To do this, open the Media Import window. Press the Import button at the top left on the toolbar to display the Media Import window. The left column has a list of sources. Click on a camera or device to display the available media in the center. In this example, I have folders of video, sound effects, and logos stored on the desktop. Preview content by clicking on a clip. For video, the image is shown at the top. Click the play button to watch the clip.
I was hoping that turns on or off something.
Below the movie is a film strip. Move the cursor across the film strip to get a preview of the content. Final Cut Pro makes editing fast because of features like the film strip view. Within a few seconds, we are able to skim across the clip and gain an understanding of what the clip is without having to watch the entire clip. Next, select which clips you want to import. Click on a single clip to select it, or hold Command and click on multiple clips. You can also click on an item, hold Shift, and click on another item to select everything in between those two points. Use the information on the right to verify these clips are going into the new Final Cut library we created earlier. It says Donut Dynamite, which is what I want. Final Cut libraries are divided into events. Events store media and projects. For smaller projects, like this documentary, only one event is used. So I'm going to select Add to Existing Event with the date. We will rename the event later. Remember earlier I created a new library and saved it on my computer's hard drive in my Movies folder. By using the option Copy to Library, all of the media being imported is copied to that library that is stored in my Movies folder. I find when editors are first learning Final Cut, it's better to let Final Cut manage the media behind the scenes, and that is what Copy to Library will do for us. You can watch other videos on this channel for more details on that. The rest of the options can stay as they are. At the bottom, click the Import button to start importing. To save time, you can continue to work while Final Cut imports the videos in the background. Track the progress of the import using the Background Tasks button. After the first step of importing, we move to the second step in the editing process, organizing. Click once to select the name of the event. Wait a second and then click it again to rename it. Notice the event is indented under the library. This indicates that this event is stored inside this library. As you progress with Final Cut Pro and your organization becomes more advanced, you'll use this area, called the library sidebar, more frequently. But for now, click this button to hide it. The buttons at the top right of the toolbar are used to hide other areas. For organizing, I hide the inspector and timeline. I'll also drag this divider to make the viewer a little smaller. We can now see more clips, which will make organizing easier. Each one of these clips represents a video, still image, or audio file. Move your cursor across any of the clips to preview them, or press the spacebar to play back the video. At the top right of the browser is the Clip Appearance and Filtering menu. Use it to zoom in or out of the clip. Notice the number on the right. That tells us how much content is being represented in one of the film strip's icons. When set to 5 seconds, this one block represents about 5 seconds of that clip. If I set it to all, that means regardless of the length of the clip, it will be represented by one block. I find this is one of the most confusing things when getting started with Final Cut, so practice with the various views. In addition to using this film strip mode, there is also a list mode. The list mode includes more data, but we are going to stick with the film strip mode in this video. One way to organize is by marking clips you want to use as favorites and reject the ones you don't. Skim across a clip. If you know you want to use it, click on it and use the Mark menu to select Favorite. Clips marked as favorite show a green line at the top of the clip. Looking at this next clip, I can tell right away that I don't want to use it. So I'll click on the clip to select it and press the Delete key on the keyboard to mark it as rejected. The clip disappears, but don't worry, it's not deleted. This menu is set to Hide Rejected. Change this to Show All, and we see the rejected clip again. Most of the time, Hide Rejected is preferred. This interview clip is about 40 minutes. Parts of the interview should be marked favorite, while other parts should be rejected. To do this, just click and drag across the part of the clip to select it. Then press the F key to mark it as a favorite. Click and drag, then let go to select a second part, and F to mark it as favorite. Same steps to reject a part. Select it, then press the Delete key. Repeat these same steps for all of your clips. And when it's time to build the project, use this menu to show just favorite clips. Reset the interface with Command 0, then click File, New Project. Stay organized by naming the project. Verify it's being added to the correct event, and use the automatic settings. If you know the format and other specs of the video you'd like to create, you can click Use Custom Settings. Otherwise, keep it at automatic and click OK. To start building the movie, add clips from the browser. Click on a clip to select it, then drag it down to the timeline. You may have heard this called the magnetic timeline. You don't have to be super specific about where a clip is dropped. Notice if I drag this clip anywhere to the right of the other clip, it's magnetically connected to the first one. Continue to add clips to build the project. You can also use these buttons. Select a clip and then press the Append to Primary Storyline button. Click on a clip, press E, click on a clip, and press E, and repeat these steps. After adding some of the interview, it's time to add some B-roll. B-roll is the secondary video that is seen while the person continues to talk in the background. Select the clip and drag it above the interview clip on the primary storyline. Similar to stacking paper on the desk in front of you, where the top piece covers up what's below it, Final Cut presents the content in a top-down fashion, meaning the clips on the top are what we are going to see first. As you edit, it can be helpful to change the view options in the timeline. Similar to the browser, click the Appearance menu and adjust the settings. As an example, seeing the audio waveform can help us edit the interview clips. Among others, the Tools menu includes the Blade and Range Selection tools. Press B to activate the blade, then click on the clip to cut it. Notice this area where the waveform drops. That means the person stopped talking. Use the blade to click and cut that part of the clip. Then press A to switch back to the Select tool. Click on the clip and press Delete to remove that portion. A quicker way to remove a selection is by pressing and holding the R key. This activates the Range Selection tool. Click and drag across the part we want to delete. Then let go of the R key. Notice it switched back to the Select tool automatically. Now you can just press the Delete key to remove that portion. After a few more edits, the project is outlined. Let's add an opening title. Click on the Titles and Generators sidebar to see the two categories. There are some useful generators, such as the placeholder, which can be used in a project for a clip you don't have yet. There is also a set of backgrounds, which we can use behind the opening title. Click and drag one of the backgrounds to the start of the project. Notice the magnetic timeline in action as all of the other clips move out of the way. Under Titles, locate the basic title. Remember, Final Cut looks top down, so the title needs to be placed above the background. The purple line represents the title and can be adjusted in length by dragging the edges. Select the title and use the inspector to adjust the font and size. Click the View menu and select Show Title Safe Zones. This feature of Final Cut is simple, but it puts lines on the screen to help you know where to position text. Keeping the text inside the lines helps avoid text getting cut off on some devices, like TV screens. We can now click and drag the text in the viewer to place it near the edge with confidence the text won't get cut off. Play back the opening and notice the cut from the opening title to the first clip. We can smooth this out by adding a transition. Open the transition browser and locate the cross dissolve. This simple transition is one of the most used. Drag the transition in between two clips to add it. Click and drag the edges to shorten the length of the transition, or click near the top of the transition to reposition it. Use the flow transition to seamlessly merge jump cuts, allowing the removal of pauses or mistakes in on-camera interviews. Easily access photo and music libraries from the Photos and Audio sidebar. Very similar to the other browsers, use this area to search for a song or sound effect, then drag it down to the timeline to add it. When the interview starts here, to better hear the person talking, I know the music should be lowered. Press R to activate the Range Selection tool. Then click and drag across the portion of audio that should be lowered. With it selected, click and drag this line down. Notice these little diamond points. These are called keyframes and allow the audio volume to change over time. They can be moved and deleted at any time. Nearing completion, the video looks okay. Using small adjustments, we can turn the video from just okay to great. Double-click the spot between two clips, also known as an edit point, to open the Precision Editor. The Precision Editor allows many minor adjustments to an edit point, such as moving the transition, adjusting where parts of the clip are displayed, and even the length of each clip. This is just a preview of some of the power included with Final Cut Pro 10, but with this tool, you can really lock down a finished product. In most workflows, the color correction is one of the last steps. With a clip selected, use the Enhancements menu to select Balance Color. This may make the video look better. Open the inspector to display the color correction options. Again, this is just a preview of what is available, but know that these tools make adjusting the look of your video easy. Final Cut includes many other advanced tools, such as the ability to add captions. These captions can then be shared to YouTube and other locations to help your videos reach a larger audience. To add a caption, simply click Edit, Captions, Add Caption. Type in the text that should be visible during that time and repeat the steps. If there's an issue, the caption will turn red. Use the inspector to determine what's wrong and correct the issue to become compliant. Once complete, you're ready to share. Click the Share menu at the top right and select a destination. Master file is a great way to create a full quality export. It's also common to share directly to YouTube or other devices from this menu. After selecting an option, fill in the name, description, and other fields listed. The bottom shows an overview of the file that will be created, including frame size, audio type, and estimated file size. Click on the Settings tab to sign in to a YouTube account. Set the resolution, which I recommend keeping at the largest available setting. I also recommend selecting better quality for the compression and private for privacy. We also want to include the captions that we spent time adding. This lets you upload the best quality video and gives you time to review the video once the upload has completed. You can then log into YouTube.com to review the video and make it public at that time. Click Next and Publish, and the upload happens in the background. Congratulations! You just got an overview of one of the most powerful video editing applications available. You may feel overwhelmed, but that's normal. There is still so much more to learn. Subscribe to this channel to get additional tips, and follow at Final Cut Pro Help on Instagram for more knowledge. Got a question? Send me a DM or email finalcutprohelp@me.com. And if you want amazing footage like the content I used in this video to practice editing, use coupon code FCPHELP, all one word, to save 15% at editstock.com.